Hi everyone, my name is Matthew. I'm a makeup artist and teacher at the Makeup Forever Academy. And today, I'm going to show you how to choose the right foundation. First, the right texture according to your skin type, and then the right color according to your skin tone. And in bonus, we'll finish with quick and easy step-by-step routines you can adopt. For today's tutorial, I have my three beautiful models, Chimelle, Geneva, and Lou. Stick around to discover all of these tips and tricks. So first, how to choose the right texture. You want to analyze your skin to determine your skin type. If your skin tends to shine a lot during the day, if your skin texture is visible and you have enlarged pores, it means that you may have combination to oily skin. You can use our new HD Skin for a medium coverage and a natural finish, or the Matte Velvet Skin Compact for a higher coverage and a matte finish. If your skin shines a bit during the day and your cheeks are a little bit dry, you have normal to combination skin. HD Skin or the water tone for a lighter coverage would be the best options. If your skin is thin with a feeling of tightness after cleansing or during the day, it can also peel on the cheeks, sides of the nose or forehead. You have dehydrated or dry skin. You can use the Reboot foundation for a medium coverage and a glowy finish, or the Ultra HD Stick foundation for a higher coverage and a satin finish. Okay, so now let's see how to choose the right color. To determine your skin color undertone, you can check the color of your veins inside your wrist. If they're green, your undertone would be yellow. If they're purple, you would be pink or red. And if they're blue, you're more neutral. Then, with all of these information, you want to select the right shade. I am going to swatch the shades on your jawline and make sure that I'm selecting the right one for you, and the perfect one for you, actually. So what you want to do, you want to take one shade after the other, and then you just want to swatch it. If the color completely disappears into your skin tone, it means that it is the perfect match. Okay, Lou, so I think we found the perfect shade for you. It's the one in the middle, right here. Okay, Lou, so if you don't have a pro makeup artist next to you, you can also use our shade finder on the Makeup Forever website. You just have to take a selfie of yourself, it's very simple. Okay, so since you have several options to choose from, it's very convenient to switch up foundations according to the time of the year. If it's winter time, if it's summertime, you know, your skin color can change, right? Yeah. And to finish, here are some quick complexion routines you can adopt according to your skin type. First, prep your skin. Since you have combination to oily skin, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the Hydra Booster first. It's going to hydrate your skin because, you know, you have an oily skin, but it needs hydration, right? So I'm gonna apply that with the brush 122. I'm going to apply the Shine Control Primer. So a bit on the forehead. What you can do is you can have like a circular motion like that, and then you can dab it on like this. So for normal to combination skin, you can use the Hydra Booster, but also the pore minimizer locally if needed. So I'm gonna prime your face with the Step 1 Primer Hydra Booster first. I'm gonna apply this all over your face. So I apply it in circular motions just to diffuse the product evenly on your face. Mm-hmm. You wanna make sure that you have, that you cover the entire face with it.
Okay. That smells good.
Right. How do you feel?
It's
feels
really
fresh, right?
Soft, yes.
Yes.
Really fresh.
A good tip for you is you can definitely put the primer in the fridge.
Okay.
And then
oh,
pour it
really?
Out when you need it. Yeah. You pour it
like
out when you need it.
In the real fridge?
In your fridge.
Okay.
It's gonna get cooler, and when you put it on your face, it's going to give you like a very tightening effect.
It's really fresh.
It's really fresh and it's beautiful. Okay, and then I'm gonna use the pore minimizer. It is going to reduce the appearance of enlarged pores. And you can apply it with your fingers. Very easy, right?
Okay.
So what I do is I warm up the product on my hand just a little bit so it's easier to apply. And then what I'm doing is I'm just swiping a little bit the product and then I'm dabbing it on like that. I'm not gonna put that everywhere, but mainly on the sides of the nose and on the cheeks right here.
Okay.
Where the pores are a little bit more visible. For dry or dehydrated skin, you can start your routine with a Skin Booster, which is a beautiful hydrating serum. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one pump of the product for the entire face. It's completely enough. Okay, so step two, apply your foundation. So for you, I have selected the Matte Velvet Skin Compact because you have a combination to oily skin. And then I'm going to apply the foundation starting from the center of your face towards the perimeter of your face.
I like this powder because I think it's so light.
I agree. It's very light and airy. And it's very easy to apply, actually. I think it's an amazing product when you are in a rush, especially in the morning. You have to go, you have to rush, you don't want to be late. It's, you know, you just swipe it on and you're good to go, right? Yeah. For normal to combination skin, I'm going to use our new HD Skin Foundation with a brush that has been especially designed for it.
Okay.
Very excited to try it.
Yes, this is an exclusive project.
It is, definitely, and it's a beautiful formula.
Okay.
You want to start from the center of your face towards the perimeter of your face, always, so it looks more natural.
Oh, the project smells really good.
For dry skin, the Reboot Foundation is absolutely amazing. It is going to hydrate your skin, but it's also going to cover any imperfections as well. So I'm going to apply the foundation with the brush 112, starting from the center towards the perimeter of the face, as always. Can you feel how the brush is soft?
Yes.
Right?
It's really soft and comfortable.
You like it?
Yeah, I really like it.
It has a very, you know,
good sensitive.
Yeah, it's the texture is absolutely amazing. Step three, apply a concealer. So for a combination to oily skin, you can use the Ultra HD Concealer or the Matte Velvet Skin Concealer. Today, I'm using the Matte Velvet Skin Concealer. It's a beautiful concealer.
Okay.
And I'm using the shade 5.3. So what I'm going to do is I am going to dab three dots of concealer under your eyes, just like that. And then I'm using the brush 226 to blend it out. So for a combination or dry skin, you can use the Ultra HD Concealer to conceal your under eye area. I'm going to apply three dots of concealer just underneath your eyes and blend it out with a brush, okay? So one, two, three. Okay. And I'm going to apply also a little bit of concealer on your lid, like that.
I never do that.
You never do that?
No.
Well, it's actually really good because it is going to give you a little bit of luminosity
okay.
to your eye as well. Okay, so step four, you have to set your makeup. I have an amazing product for you. It is called the Light Velvet Air Mist. So do you want to try it yourself? Yep. Okay, so you just have to.
Okay, thank you.
You hold the bottle 30 centimeters away from your face, okay, and three pumps is enough for the entire face.
Oh my God, it's so refreshing.
So for normal to combination skin, the last step would be to set your foundation with the Ultra HD Setting Powder. Starting on your T-zone first, what you want to do is you want to dab it on first like that, on your T-zone, on your forehead, on your nose, and on your chin. This time I'm swiping the product like this on your face. There you go. All done.
Amazing. You like it?
I love it. You look fab.
This is amazing. I like it.
So for dry skin, I'm going to use the Ultra HD Loose Powder, which is a translucent powder, and it's very thin. It's very airy. So it's going to make your skin look absolutely luminous and glowy and beautiful, but it's going to set your foundation as well, so it stays in place throughout the day. So final step, the mist and fix. It's a setting spray that you use to set your makeup. This is the final step, the last one. And you have to hold it 30 centimeters away from your face. Three sprays completely enough. Do you want to try it?
Yes.
Okay. And voila, you're done.
Thank you, I like it so much.
Thank you, you look beautiful. So guys, this is the end. I truly hope this video was helpful for you. Don't hesitate to ask us for more pro tips in the comment section down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. See you guys next time. Bye.